In this video, we're going to show you a great concept of how you could choose to paint your army, and that is if it's fire spirits who have literally taken form with bodies of magma. Now, if you want to do this, what you should do is undercoat your miniatures using Wraithbone spray, which you can see is what I've done for my example just here. And then what we're going to do is start out by dry brushing it using Flashkit's yellow, but we're going to do it in a slightly unusual way compared to how I normally dry brush. I'm going to be using a medium dry brush to do this, and what we do is just get a bit of that paint onto the brush like this, and then rather than using tissue to work the paint into the bristles, instead I'm going to use the palette. And the reason for this is it won't absorb away quite so much moisture, meaning the paint's going to retain a little bit in there, be a bit thinner, a bit smoother. So as I apply this, it won't be quite as dry as a normal dry brush would be and give a smoother finish. So still, I'm going to do the same sort of technique though, just making sure we get rid of the excess paint off the brush. And once you've done so, we're then ready to start applying it to the body. And what we're going to do is apply it in a circular motion like this, the goal being to cover most of it with yellow, but leaving white in the very deepest recesses. Once you've built up the yellow to this point, you're then ready to move on to the next colour, which is Troll Slayer Orange. And for this, we're going to be doing the same kind of technique, only this time we want less paint on the brush. So I'm just going to get a little bit on there like that, and then as before, use the palette rather than some tissue to work it into the bristles, because the goal here is that we want to get less orange on than we had yellow. So this way we'll get a transition going from white in the deepest recesses through to yellow and then to the orange. So once you've really got rid of most of that paint, we're ready to start applying it, and I'm just going to be quite light as I put this on to begin with and gradually add more. So you see it's the same kind of technique, that circular motion, just building up the colour so that yellow is showing through the further down into the body you go. With that orange applied, you can see the fiery effect is really starting to build up, and what we need to do now is carry on really building up the colours to get to the end point. And the first colour we're going to be applying is Wild Rider Red, but this time we're going to be dry brushing it. And then we're going to move on to Corn Red, which again we're going to dry brush, and finally a Bad and Black to finish it off, once again as a dry brush. We're going to be starting out with Wild Rider Red though, and now I'm going to be using a small dry brush to apply it, and we want even less paint than we had previously. So a small amount on your brush, get it on the tissue, work away the excess paint and work it into the bristles as well until there's hardly anything there. And then what we're going to do is very softly start building this up on top of the colours we've got already. So again, that circular motion like this so that we get that red appearing towards the middle of these orange areas that we've been getting, you see? So it's getting redder the further away from the middle of the body we go. Next, we're ready to move on to Corn Red, once again dry brushed onto the miniature, just a little bit lighter than before. And finally, apply a very light dry brush of a Bad and Black, and this is going to be just in those coolest areas, so the middle of the reddish places, furthest away from the core of the body. And there we are, with that fire effect built up, we now just have one more little thing left to do, and that is to paint in the eyes of the miniature to be kind of the focal point of it. And for this, we need White Scar. So I'm going to be using a small airbrush to apply this because we only need a very small amount of it. So use your palette to help make sure that it's under control and that it's thinned down nicely. And you want to get it down to around about that sort of texture like that. And then just get rid of the excess paint off your brush, and then all we need to do is paint a very small amount of this in the middle of the eye for where the model's going to be the hottest. Now, once done this, all you've got to do is base your miniature. And for such a bright colour scheme like this, we recommend going the complete opposite on the base and going really dark. So what I'm going to do is apply some texture paint to it, but then I'm going to paint that a Bad and Black so that the base is a really, really dark texture. And with that dark base fully painted, this flesh hound made from animated lava is complete. So if you're going to use this technique, there's a couple of key things to bear in mind, and the first is that we did quite a lot of dry brushing on this miniature, and that dry brushing is kind of in reverse, where we're looking for darker colour on the raised areas. The key to getting this right is to make sure that you only apply a very small amount at once, so you can slowly build up the colour, especially as you get to those darker colours where you want less and less of it to actually catch on the miniature. The other thing is that early on when we were dry brushing, we actually used the palette rather than any tissue to work the paint into the bristles, and the reason for this was that we wanted to keep some moisture in the brush so that the paint would apply a little bit smoother than normal. But there you go, that's really all you need to know to use this technique, and we really hope you guys found it interesting. We'll see you all again very soon.